IP rating, sometimes called IP code, is an international standard which classifies the degree of ingress protection provided by an enclosure of electrical equipment with a rated voltage of 72.5 kilovolts or below. So that's phones, smartwatches, cameras, headphones, bike lights, and all kinds of PEVs, including electric scooters. Essentially, it is a system to help identify how well an enclosure can prevent solids and liquids from entering. And a typical IP rating will be made up of the letters IP, which is ingress protection, and two numbers. The first of which represents intrusion from solids. So that's starting with zero, that's no protection. One, which should have protection from a large body part such as a hand from entering, all the way up to six, which is totally dust tight. But when it comes to PEVs, you will typically see five or six here. That's either partial protection from dust or dust tight. And that's all good, not much to worry about, which is reinforced by the fact that you usually see an X in place for that first number, which simply means that the value for that number is missing. So the meat and potatoes of the IP rating discussion is usually around the second number, which represents moisture protection. Here again, zero means no protection, so starting at one, protected against vertical falling drops of water, all the way up to 9K, which is protection against high pressure, high temperature jet sprays, washdowns, or steam cleaning procedures, which would be incredible to have. However, we have yet to see a PEV with such a rating. You'll typically see ratings of 4 through 8, with 4 being the most common, which is protection against splashing water in all directions. 5 is protection against low pressure water jets. 6 is protection against high pressure water jets. 7 is protection against full immersion for up to 30 minutes. And 8 is protection against extended immersion at greater depths. And looking at this list here, we can see that IPX4 is indeed the most common. Now, this is not an exhaustive list. I just looked up the IP ratings of a bunch of popular scooters. The IPX4 list is overflowing with good contenders for fair weather riding. IPX5 is cut in half with some rainworthy scoots. And above that, I only came across 6 scooters. So that's the Apollo City, Apollo Air, an eMove Cruiser at IPX6, Quickwheel S1C, and Segway P65 and P100S with IPX7, and a single scooter at the top, the Vig Yersa, with a rating of IPX8. And a couple of these have mixed ratings, which means they have separate ratings for the battery and controller, and then another rating for the rest of the scooter. And those are the Segway models with the overall rating of IPX5, and the Yersa, which has an IPX7 for the screen and an IPX5 for the rest of the scooter. Which leaves only the Apollo City, Apollo Air, eMove Cruiser, and Quickwheel to have an overall rating higher than IPX5. And that's big if true, because one place in particular that's really quite difficult to keep water out is the hub motor, which happens to be a feature on every scooter. Rusted motors are a common sight, and it makes me wonder how Quickwheel does it. As for rentals, Lime and Bird claim to have ratings of IP67 and IP68 respectively, pretty much a necessity for their business. A noteworthy point is that the ratings don't necessarily stack. So for example, a scooter with a rating of IPX7 may not be able to pass a high pressure spray. And if it did pass multiple tests, it could be labeled with multiple ratings. That being said, it is generally accepted that the higher the number, the better. Now, all those ratings sound great on paper, but you might actually be wondering who is doing the testing. Well, it's probably independent certified companies who follow guidelines and test products. Basically, they have specialized equipment designed to create repeatable test environments to see if these things can keep water out. And I say probably because it's hard to tell if they are even using these independent companies to test their products. I haven't found the answer to that yet, but if you know, please share in the comments. But even if they do, it doesn't necessarily mean a company selling PEVs can't put a favorable spin on the results. It's been seen in other industries where marketing has been a bit south, though they haven't been without repercussions. Both Apple and Samsung received fines from consumer watchdogs in Italy and Australia, respectively, for their misleading waterproof marketing. So there seems to be at least some incentive to be forthright, but even then, what are these ratings worth if the companies touting them don't stand behind their products when water damage occurs? Because you may have noticed that no scooter manufacturer even guarantees these ratings and do not cover water damage. Well, at least most of them, there's only one company out of the previously listed that covers water damage, which of course is Vig, and only for the Yersa, they offer full warranty against water damage. And considering that lack of support from the vast majority of companies, it's no surprise that DIY waterproofing is a common thread. It is an option, however, it's not something that I recommend because it is possible to create problems rather than solve them. And to be honest, I don't think that the average scooter user is interested in taking on that endeavor. I am more interested in seeing a wider range of water-resistant options right out of the box. You can do all the lab testing you want, but nothing beats the real world. The proof is in the pudding. The real world water resistance isn't really known until after a year or so of real testing from the community. So in the end, IP ratings are part marketing and part science, and there's no real waterproof scooter yet. My name is Nick. Thanks for watching.